But Leonard, the big moment here in 24 hours, Gervonta Tank Davis, the most exciting fighter of boxing, as you would say, is stepping in the ring, Mario Barrios. What could we expect?
You know, fireworks. You know, anytime a Tank Davis event, you know what it's about. Another packed, sold-out event, and again, star-studded event. You know, just really, really looking forward to see what Barrios brings to the table tomorrow. You know, I know he's had a tremendous camp, and there's actually a little bad blood going now.
I saw that.
You know, so again, it's going to be really exciting tomorrow. I expect a knockout.
If Tank does pull it off, what does that mean? What does that say? Where does that put him in the boxing world right now?
It just continues to elevate him and show that, you know, what he's capable of. Again, making the jump, two-weight class, that's just, I mean, it's just something that's incredible. I was just talking with Phelps, Michelle Phelps, a little bit ago, and I was like, you know, some of the criticisms, it's mind-boggling with some of these purists, per se. You know, they said, oh, well, this guy's in the real champ, he isn't a champ. I said, well, okay, what would be the difference if we say, like, the Lopez kid? He moved up two weight classes to welterweight and wanted to fight Sean Porter or Keith Thurman. What would you guys be saying?
Amazing. Great move. Congratulations. It's impressive.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. We know Errol Spence is the dude. He's the guy everybody's gunning for. But say he moved up to fight one of those two guys.
Yep.
What kind of conversation would be happening with the peers?
They would go crazy in a good way.
Right?
Yeah.
So really, what is the difference? I'm asking you that question.
I'm a big supporter of Tank. I think it's amazing. There's very few fighters in history that could do it, and I'm excited for the fight. At first he says he fights people too small. Now they're saying, oh, this guy doesn't have a belt. First of all, he does have a belt, but just watch the fight. He's undefeated, 26-0. It's a dangerous fight.
And it's a good-ass fight. And so instead of the fans embracing the diehards, embracing that part of it, you know, they look for other reasons. That's why the one thing what we've mastered, we give zero fucks about what others think. You know, we're going to give the fans the biggest and best fights, but they're going to be the timing-wise, we're going to dictate the timing, and he can't fight everybody in the same night.
Yeah,
you know, he's fight. This is a tough-ass fight. He's moving up two weight classes fighting. He's fighting some chump. Mario Barrios, he's the real deal. You know, he's young, undefeated himself, okay? And we know what he brings to the table. Again, I think it's a great matchup.
But
and when Tank goes to do what he needs to do, then people
but,
should support
But Leonard, him. Two things. I don't think the boxing purists, they're few in numbers, but they make sound like a million. But it's a very minimal number, number one. Number two, Tank appeals to so many other fan bases. I keep telling people he's a crossover star. He doesn't just appeal to the hardcore boxing fans, and we'll see that.
But Ellie, you made a great point. And see, the purists, the diehards, whatever the term you want to use, it's not many. It's not many. And either they're going to support the event or they're not going to support the event. And it's okay. But we've mastered and what we understand that in order to become a global star, you got to think outside of the purists. And what Tank has been able to do, he's been able to attract a whole new generation of fans because he's the most exciting fighter out there in the entire sport. And so that's what they want to see. And again, these are paying customers. And again, whether it's been the UK, whether it's been Brooklyn, whether it's been LA, whether it's been Baltimore, or even Atlanta, you get the same thing, a packed sold out event. And you know that Gervonta Davis is coming to bring it and give you nothing but excitement, and he's looking to knock everybody out.
Last thing, Leonard, we're here for Evander. When do we get to see Floyd Mayweather with his statue?
Wow, that's a great question. That's going to happen. That's definitely going to happen. Floyd deserves every accolade that's out there. And again, that's definitely going to happen.
You heard it from Leonard.
This man here filmed me teaching Brandon Rios how to speak Chinese before he went to China.
Yep.
Oh, wow.
I remember that.
You remember that?
Yeah, of course. You did a great job. Yeah. He didn't remember, but you did it. Thank you, Leonard.
You get that.